Hi, welcome to video 3 of the Guitar Accelerator, 7 Secrets to Supercharge Your Progress on the Guitar. In the last 2 videos, we talked about the importance of making sure that your guitar is actually in the best shape it can be and is the best fit for you. And then we talked about the importance of making sure that it's in good tune and that you actually take the time to tune it when you're going to play. In this video, we're going to talk about the importance of having a plan, of having a roadmap. When you sit down to play and you are actively wanting to get to be a better guitar player, what do you do? I get this question all the time from students. I don't know how to use my practice time to the best results. And so today we're going to talk about that a little bit. I guess the best way to characterize the way that I structure a practice session for myself and for my students is to think of it in terms of the number 3, okay? The overall practice session itself is going to have 3 components, okay? Within that practice session, the middle section will have its own 3 components, but we're always thinking in 3s here. So the first thing you want to do when you sit down to practice your guitar after you've tuned it is to warm up. You know, you wouldn't jump into any kind of an athletic pursuit having just gotten off the couch where you've been watching movies all day. You have to warm up your muscles and your joints and your tendons and get them ready. I will show you how to do that. Not in this video, but I will show you how to do that. So that's step 1 of a good practice session. Warm up so that you're really ready to work. Step 2 in a good practice session. This is again the part in the middle that we're going to break into 3 sections. What this is I want you to decide one topic that you're going to work on first. If you have a short practice session, it might be just one topic, period. If you have an hour to spend, you might do 2 or 3 topics. Pick a topic that you want to work on during today's practice session. It could be a song, it could be some scales, it could be some techniques and skills and exercises. Whatever it is, I'm going to pick the topic, and now we're going to break that topic down into 3 chunks. I'm going to pretend that for today my topic is practicing the song Amazing Grace. I'm trying to learn how to play Amazing Grace. First thing I want to do is I'm assuming that you have a written material of some sort, a tablature or a song sheet or something like that that you're working from. Get that out and just preview it. Look it over and play it the best you can right now. Okay, so you've warmed up your fingers, but you haven't warmed up to this particular song yet. So this first time through is what I call getting the song into the room. Let's just play it and see what's going on. Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like... Uh-oh, I forgot how to do a G chord. Not really. Anyway, the idea being, you're playing through the song the first time through and kind of also scanning for trouble spots, okay? What are the spots that really want you to come back and work on them? All right, so that's part one, is previewing the song and getting the song into the room and identifying what specific spots are falling behind the spots that are going really well. I discovered that my fingers aren't really great at going from C to G in a timely manner. They got kind of confused. So part two of this section of the practice session will be to focus on that particular skill, switching from C to G. So I'm going to take a look at my C chord. I'm going to take a look at where I'm headed for the G chord. And I'm just going to practice that back and forth until it feels comfortable. Then I'm going to practice it with a strum. Make sure it sounds good. And then I'm going to practice it with the rhythm of the song. And by practice, I mean do that several times. You're trying to bring that rough section up to the standard of the parts that you're playing the best. I'm moving through these steps very quickly. Ideally, I'd like you to spend at least 5 or 10 minutes on each of these segments, on the getting the song into the room, on each of the rough spots, and then the third segment is to go back to the entire project, back to the whole song, and see if you can integrate the things you've just been drilling yourself on into the bigger piece. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved. So let's refer to that idea of taking a single topic, breaking it into three sections, sort of getting the song into the room or getting the scale into the room, whatever it is you're working on. Section one. Section two, having identified what the weak spots are, work on them. Work on them in a very methodical way. Step three, put the whole thing together again. So you're playing the whole piece again, having reintegrated those rough spots that you've been working on. Okay? That's how you practice one single topic. Now that may be all you have time for in a day, or you can pick another topic and do the same exact thing. Break it into those three chunks. Okay? So that's the middle section of your guitar practice session. We talked about, first of all, you're going to warm up your fingers. First of all, you're going to tune and warm up your fingers. Then you're going to practice these, essentially these three-part modules based on each topic that you're wanting to work on and that you have time for. Finally, the last 5 or 10 minutes of the session, I want you to do something fun, okay? Just play something that is easy and fun so that you end up leaving the practice session feeling good, relaxed, and happy, and not sort of stressed out about how hard you've been working. Okay, so that's our three-part roadmap to a perfect practice session. In the next video, let's take a look at those warm-up exercises that will get your hands in shape to do the best work you can do when you're practicing and learning the guitar.